A lot of people call this a planet. Scientists call it Earth. Environmentalists call it Mother Earth. But I call this my home. The survival of all things on Earth depends on the harmonious and healthy relationship between things found in nature, whether natural or man-made, be it large or small. Humans, as stewards of nature, are responsible to safeguard and protect the delicate balance in the community of living things which interact with the non-living. Therefore, old and young, we must understand how this system of life works called the ecosystem. Watch as I give you a glimpse of how these living and non-living things live, interact, and depend on each other in their community called estuary. An estuary is a semi-enclosed body of water where fresh water coming from land such as river meets and mixes with salt water coming from the open sea like an ocean. It is shallow than the ocean. Although influenced by the tides, they are protected from the full force of ocean waves, winds, and storms by landforms such as barrier islands or peninsulas. Being an irregularly shaped archipelago comprising of 7,641 islands, estuaries are very common in the Philippines. The most famous of these are the Manila Bay and the underground estuary in Palawan, the Puerto Princesa Underground River. It was declared UNESCO's World Heritage Site and made it into the world's new Seven Wonders of Nature in 2012. Typically, the salinity of estuaries are influenced by tides and season. In the Philippines, flooding during typhoons and rainy seasons also affects such salinity because of an increased river runoff from the uplands. Estuaries are home to a rich biodiversity of life. Biotic factors are the living organisms in estuaries, as well as the abiotic factors or the non-living things in there, such as the sun, air, water, and soil, among others, interact with each other to survive. Since estuaries are full of decaying plants and animals, this makes the soil of estuaries rich in nutrients. Because the soil is so rich, lots of different plants grow in estuaries with the help of the sun through the process called photosynthesis. Plants attract lots of different animals to the estuary, and those animals attract other animals to the estuary. Therefore, estuaries are a kingdom of the flora and fauna. Plants living in estuaries need to adapt to salty conditions, such as pickleweed, which can absorb the salt water and store the salt in special compartments called vacuoles in the leaves. Other plants, like saltgrass, are able to push the salt out onto the surface of the leaves. The salt crystals can be seen if you look very closely. Other plants that you will find in the estuaries are salt marsh, moss, and mangrove trees, among others. Estuaries are also often called the nurseries of the ocean. Many fish species lay their eggs in estuaries. The abundant plant life in estuaries provides a safe place for young fish to live. At least 30 species of fish use estuaries at some stage in their life cycle, including snapper, flounder, mullet, red cod, eel, salmon, whitebait, and sharks. Many of the fish we eat depend upon estuaries. They are sheltered places where fish can have their young, and the young fish can grow before moving out into the open ocean. The life is diverse, yet connected, interdependent for its own survival. Without estuaries, the number of fish in our oceans would decrease greatly. The complex food web found in an estuary helps to support an amazing diversity of animals. Primary producers, called the autotrophs, like plankton and plants, use the sunlight to sustain themselves. Primary consumers are the herbivores, such as sunfish, shellfish, and filter feeders convert the energy from the primary producers into biomass through consumption. Secondary consumers, usually carnivores such as crabs, birds, and small fish, prey upon the primary consumers for their energy. Tertiary consumers, usually large fish and birds, prey upon secondary consumers for their energy. Finally, apex predators, including dolphins, sharks, and humans, make up the highest trophic level of the estuarine food web by exploiting large fish and crabs. There is no other better way to explain this ecosystem but to focus on our star estuarine animal, the turtles. The estuaries of the island of Luzon in the Philippines is home to the Pelocalis cantori, or canter for short, a frog-faced soft-shell turtle due to its odd facial features. This oviparous animal grows up to 60 to 100 centimeters and lays around 24 to 70 eggs during their breeding season from June to September, where they find a place on land to lay their eggs, dig a nest into the sand or dirt, and then walk away just like any other turtle. Turtles help in keeping the balance in an ecosystem. Barnacles, algae, and other microorganisms that are stuck in the cater shells provide food to shrimp and fish. These fish and shrimps, including crabs, mollusks, and jellyfish, in addition to vegetation, are eaten by turtles who are actually omnivores. Turtles are also prey to other animals both in land and water, and are most vulnerable to predation as eggs, hatchlings, and juveniles. In water, larger fish like sharks and octopus hunt turtles as food. A long list of terrestrial animals like ants, crabs, rats, raccoons, foxes, coyotes, feral cats, dogs, mongoose, vultures, and seabirds are known to dig up unhatched nests. Worst of all, turtles face possible extinction in the hands of humans. For instance, canters are under threat from harvesting by local people for meat, accidental killing and persecution from fishermen when caught in fishing gear, and the destruction of its freshwater and coastal habitats due to pollution, industrialization, and development. Estuaries are valuable for a number of reasons. They help maintain fish populations in the ocean, and without them, we would have fewer fish to eat. They filter the river water that flows into them, helping to keep our ocean water clean and safe for everyone to enjoy. Estuaries likewise create a natural barrier that absorbs the energy of the waves and prevents them from flooding cities, destroying houses, and injuring people from storms and typhoons. Humans benefit so much from them as they are used as fishing grounds, as transport areas for human commerce and trades, as receptacle for waste, and as sites for human habitations, among others. It is for these reasons that they are in danger. We therefore have to keep the balance and integrity of our estuaries by planting trees and other vegetations. Sedimentation, which is the problem in estuaries, may be prevented by limiting erosion. The quantity and size of fish and shellfish that can be taken may also be limited or restricted to prevent excessive harvesting. Efforts to lessen, if not eliminate, the use and consumption of goods and products that contribute in the pollution of these water forms should be effected immediately and, if possible, practice reduce, reuse, and recycle. It is not just our bodies that should be maintained clean and healthy. Even the environment that surrounds us need caring and protection. Let us make a difference and do our part as stewards for our nature to nurture and for our world to be a better and healthier place. Heal the world, make it a better place.